Hello, I am Bob, and this is the Home Bitcoin Immersion Mining Channel. And in this build series episode, I'm going to cover how I fix my Bitcoin clothes dryer and share some of my thoughts about commercialization. So with that, let's get started. But before getting on with the video, I want to mention some sponsors of the channel, the first being Brains. Now, I have been using the Brains OS firmware on my miners for quite a while, and two of the reasons for that choice are auto-tuning and dynamic performance scaling. The Brains OS auto-tuning ensures you're getting the best performance out of your miners, and dynamic performance scaling can be used to protect your miners from the cooling variability we often see in home setups. Together, the Brains OS auto-tuning and dynamic performance scaling create the perfect running conditions for your mining hardware. And if you are still using stock firmware on your miners, you really should consider stepping up your miner performance with the Brains OS. Now, my next sponsor is Scott's Crypto Mining and the Build-A-Mine Bootcamp. In the Build-A-Mine Bootcamp, you'll learn everything you need to know to launch your first megawatt of Bitcoin miners in less than 3 months. The Build-A-Mine Bootcamp is taught by Scott himself, and you'll be joined by other entrepreneurs and business owners like you who want to learn how to stack more sats faster through Bitcoin mining on an industrial scale. To get in on this fantastic opportunity, just click the link in the description below. And last up is the mining hardware supplier for the channel, Altair Bitcoin Mining Solutions. Altair is your one-stop shop for any mining hardware you might need. They have everything from the latest and greatest miners to every hashboard, cable, and part you might need to repair your existing hardware or build your own 120-volt home-built miner. Altair has years of experience working in the Bitcoin mining industry, running their own mining farm, and they've worked with all different scales of mining operations. Altair is based in the US and has top-rated customer support. And so if you have any question about anything at any time, they are there to help you out. Altair is a huge supporter of the home mining community, so if you're looking to buy your next miner or miner parts for your home setup, check out their website at the link below. You'll find pretty much everything you'll ever need. Okay, so in the last couple episodes, I've been covering heating a clothes dryer with the heat generated from Bitcoin mining. In my first dryer heating episode, I covered the basic challenges of using miners to heat a clothes dryer and how immersion cooling can solve some of those problems. And in the following episode, I put this information to use and built an immersion tank, a pump, radiator, and connected it to a used dryer. I have a link above to my dryer playlist so you can catch up with the build. Now, in that last video, I got everything up and running and tried doing some laundry. I started up the dryer with my switch in Bitcoin mode, sending power to my miner. The dryer drum was rotating. My immersion tank was circulating fluid. My booster fan was blowing warm air into the sealed dryer housing. And my S19 was mining Bitcoin at full speed. But that didn't last too long. Very quickly, my miner started to overheat. I did everything I could with my Brains OS firmware to limit the miner power and increase the allowable miner temperature, but it didn't help. Even at the lowest power settings, the miner was still overheating. Also, the temperature of the air coming out of my radiator was only about 115 degrees Fahrenheit, which is way too cool to dry some laundry. So, with my first attempt at building a Bitcoin dryer not working out, I had to regroup and rebuild. And when I looked at how the miner was overheating and saw the low output temperature, to me, this meant that my radiator stack was the problem. It wasn't pulling enough heat out of my immersion fluid to keep the miner cool, and it wasn't adding enough heat to the air passing through the radiator. And honestly, this wasn't too much of a surprise. Radiator heat transfer calculations can be tricky, and so for this build, I kind of took a rough guess at how many radiators I'd need. I figured I'd need at least 4, so I started there. And now that I know it doesn't work, the first fix was to increase the size of my stack by adding additional radiators. I drained the dielectric fluid and disassembled the system. I took my radiator stack and added two more 8-inch by 8-inch radiators. This gives me a combined radiator thickness of 24 inches with 18 rows of copper tubing. Now, with the bigger radiator, I figured I'd need a little more power to pull the air through the stack and send it into the dryer, so I also replaced my booster fan with a more powerful fan capable of 190 CFM. Now, this flow rate is a lot higher than what dryers are built for, but I figured that the excess airflow wouldn't hurt. I put everything back together and started up the system to see if it made a difference. And at first, my fixes seemed to be working. My miner and immersion fluid was heating up at a much slower rate, and I was able to run without overheating. I also measured the output air temperature, and I was getting readings of about 125 to 130 degrees Fahrenheit. But again, that didn't last. I kept my dryer running for a couple hours, and over time, everything started to overheat again. So again, I had to figure out what was going wrong. Now, taking a closer look at my mining setup, what I discovered is as the tank and radiator heated up, they were heating up the air around my setup. My dryer is inset into a large closet, and so all of this hot air was rising up and accumulating at the top of the closet. The radiator inlet is only 4 inches from the top, and so my radiator was just pulling in more and more of the hot air as the system heated up. So I needed to find a way to ensure my radiator was always getting a steady supply of cool input air. So again, I had to change my setup, and this fix was fairly easy. I fabricated a simple ducting inlet to sit on top of the radiator stack, and I also added a second fan to the top of the radiator. This ensured that I always had cool air entering the radiator. And with everything ready to go, I tried again to dry my clothes with Bitcoin heat. And this time, the miner worked great. I still couldn't run the miner at full power, but I could run it as long as I wanted at lower power without overheating. I also measured the air outlet temperature of the radiator stack, and I could hit temperatures up to 130 degrees Fahrenheit, which was in the right ballpark to dry clothes. But even though the miner was running well and I had some useful hot air, my clothes were still not drying. I'd open up the dryer and everything would be damp and feel around room temperature. So again, some more troubleshooting was needed. And here my focus turned to the dryer itself. When I attached my ducting to the dryer, I put the inlet right next to the heating element, but I didn't do anything else to direct that airflow. My hot air was just entering the internal cavity of the dryer, and I hoped the dryer fan was powerful enough to suck in that hot air into the drum, but that wasn't working out. Dryers are just big metal boxes with a big metal drum inside, and all of this metal was acting as a huge heat sink, absorbing all of the heat from my miner. Very little of my hot air was going where it was needed. So once again, I opened up my dryer and I fabricated some internal ducting to direct my hot air directly into the inlet of the existing heating element. I put everything back together and tried again. And this time, with all of these minor fixes in place, the system finally really worked. I was getting enough heat into the dryer to slowly dry my laundry using Bitcoin mining heat. Now, this build was a lot of fun for me. I really enjoy working around challenges like this dryer where it put constraints on the design. I had to try again and again and again to try and fix things and eventually got to build things up and see it work. But the bigger question I was after and why I took on this build was just to see if this might be a commercially viable option. Does it really make sense to dry your clothes with Bitcoin, or is this just going to be something that are for hobbyists like myself? And out of this build, I have a proof of concept to hopefully answer that question. This build shows that it is possible to heat your dryer with Bitcoin mining, and also shows the basic architecture components for putting a system like this together. But the other purpose of proof of concept builds like this is to identify key problems that have to be solved to make this viable. And for this type of system, the big challenge to solve is to find a higher temperature miner. With my S19J Pro, it takes about a half a day of continuous cycles to dry a load of laundry. This is really not practical for a real system. And the big reason why it takes this long is the output temperature I'm getting from my radiator is only about 125 to 130 degrees Fahrenheit. This is a lot lower than the normal air temperature that's used inside of dryers, which is around 150 to 160 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, the air flow rate could be increased to help solve that problem, but in most old homes like my own, the dryer vent coming out of the dryer and going to the exterior of the house goes through my ceiling, goes through exterior walls. I really can't resize that to handle a higher airflow. So this limitation is really something kind of built into this type of problem. Now, right now, most miners are designed for the big mining operations. They're designed for efficiency, for power use. They're really not designed for high temperature output. And so to make this work, we kind of need a new generation of mining chips created. We would need chips that are capable of running at much higher temperatures, which would give us higher temperature heat output, which would be perfect for this type of application. Now, there are some high temperature chip technologies out there, something like silicon carbide, gallium nitride, gallium arsenide, but generally those are made for very high performance applications, and making ASIC chips out of that technology may not be economically viable. But one of the advantages of this use case is that I don't need a high efficiency chip. I just need something that produces high temperature. Even if the efficiency was really poor, I'm still using the electricity to dry my clothes, so even if I make just a little Bitcoin on top of that electricity cost, I'm still seeing a beneficial situation. So really, we just need any chip that operates at high temperature, even if the efficiency is not that good. Now, as I said before, this build was a ton of fun for me, and I hope you enjoy watching these episodes. And if you want to see more episodes covering my other builds, click here.